I would like to thank the organizer for this opportunity to introduce our work. The theoretical calculation of a pionic helium spectroscopy. And thanks Masaki Holly's great talk. They will save me some time to repeat the introduction. However, there are some facts that I would like to mention again. First of all, the charged pion involved in all three fundamental interactions in the standard model. And the pionic helium spectroscopy can be used to determine the pion mass. Therefore, we can study the neutrino mass by studying by measuring pion mass. And as you can see, that similar to antiproton helium spectroscopy, pionic helium can be generated in a similar way and can be calculated to very high precision. And in 2014, Hollis and his co-workers present a scheme to measure the spectroscopy of pionic helium. And they also provide theoretical predictions for transitions. The theory included the long relativistic energy, the leading order relativistic and radiative corrections. Therefore, the precision is limited to around 3 to 5 ppm due to the charged pion mass value. It should be pointed out that in the theoretical calculation, recoil corrections in the leading order relativistic and radiative correction were not considered. In 2020 year, the first transition was measured at PSI, and the difference between theory and experiment is, was understood as the collisional shift between a pionic helium and helium ground state. They are planning to measure the narrower transition 17-16 to 16-15. And the precision goal is about 10 ppb. Therefore, we would like to present our calculation on this transition. Since the metal stable states of pionic helium is a resonant state, we should calculate the resonant energies and widths. The complex coordinate rotation method is widely used to calculate the resonant states in atom and molecular physics. Under this transformation, the Hamiltonian of Schrodinger equation is transferred as follows, and therefore the wave function of the regional state is then square integrable and can be calculated in a similar way of bound states. In traditional CCR method, in order to determine the energy and width of regional state, one should draw a figure similar to this example. And the different color or line means a different value of dilatation parameter. Here, phi is the rotational angle. One has to read the energy and the half width from this figure. Although this method can reach very high precision, we can further improve this algorithm. We develop a new optimization algorithm for this for CCR method, and by using the variational method, since the complex value, there is no such way to find extreme value of complex energy. We defined these two functions to find the extreme value of these two functions to making the variation of energy to be zero by gradation, gradient optimization. This algorithm has been published last year in China, a Chinese physical review B. Here is an example of the optimization progress in PS minus ion. And we use a basis function in this type. The nonlinear parameters are all real and positive. You can see that we start the same point and reach the same end by using two different optimization paths. In the by using this algorithm, we can search the original point without manual adjustment on variational parameters. Here is our results on different three body Coulombic systems, such as PS minus ion, hydrogen minus ion, helium double excited states, and the antiproton helium. Here is the coordinate we use for pionic helium, and you can see that, the kinetic and potential operators for the Hamiltonian are expressed as follows. Here is our result of the energy and the widths for the metal stable states of pionic helium. And we are interested in these two states. They can be calculated to very high precision to have more than 13 reliable digits or more. And the next, we should calculate relativistic and radiative corrections. According to QED theory, the energy can be expanded in powers of fine structure as this expansion. N is a contribution of order alpha N and maybe include powers of log alpha and we call it corrections. The first one is the eigenvalue of a non-relativistic Hamiltonian. And the next order is the leading order relativistic correction and nuclear size effects. And at here H2 is spin independent Brett Pauli Hamiltonian, including relativistic corrections of the electron, the kinetic corrections of heavy particles and retardation terms. For the operators appeared in the non-relativistic corrections, we should calculate they should be calculated to very high precision. Therefore, we use the global operator method, which is developed for non-Hermitian operators using the Schrodinger equation under the CCR method. Therefore, the operator is expanded in several terms. Here is our result of these operators. We also consider recoil corrections in the leading order relativistic corrections. The first one is kinetic correction for heavy particles and the retardation terms. Here is our results in atomic units. The next order is the leading order radiative corrections. It contains a Beth logarithm and this term, and it can be expressed in this complex expression and delta operator, which have been calculated in the Q terms. The Beth logarithm is difficult, but fortunately, it has been calculated by Schwartz approach developed by Vladimir Klobov for hydrogen molecular ion and antiproton helium. Here we apply this method to the pionic helium as well. And we get 6 reliable digits for these two states. The next order is the alpha 4 order contribution, which include the relativistic and radiative corrections. In the relativistic correction, it contains the first order correction and the second order correction. The first order correction comes from the one electron bound in two center potential phi. The relativistic correction can be calculated in the Born-Oppenheimer approximation to get a sufficient precision. The BO wave function contains the electronic wave function and the wave function for the relativistic relative nuclear motion. The effective potential have been calculated by Vladimir and Toshibaya in 2007. Here is the potential curve for anti-proton helium, and which can be used in pionic helium as well. One can obtain the relativistic correction by averaging this curve over the radial wave function to get results. And we also need to consider the vibrational correction due to the motion of nuclei. Here is our result for the relativistic and adiabatic correction. And the in the radiative correction part, it is no difficulty to get high precision. The last contribution we consider is the alpha 5 order corrections. The dominant part of this order is the electron bounded by the two center feed, which can be calculated in the atomic hydrogen approximation. And the coefficients are taken from the atomic hydrogen case. This approximation is sufficient to achieve a precision of PPB level. Here is the transition results if we sum up of the corrections. And our calculation achieve a precision of 4 PPB, which is sufficient for the current experimental goal. There would be lead to pion mass to about PPB level. Or here is our result for other transitions in gigahertz units. It should be pointed out that we also calculate the collisional shift for the pion helium and the helium ground state at a helium density of this density. And these results have been published recently. And finally, I would like to thank my PhD student, by my friend, Vladimir Klobov, my colleague, Zhong Chaoyan, and Ting Yis. Thank you for your attention. That's all.
Thank you very much, Zhen-Xiang. Any question? No. Single sphere. So maybe I have one. I saw on slide 15, just a curiosity, it's a really naive question on your slide 15.
Sorry?
You can go to slide 15. Yeah, is it okay?
this transition of
no, it was light 15, but it was just a question on the accuracy. It looked very different from the odd transition to the even transitions, or it was just something I
you mean this table, the transition here, or
yes, exactly, yes. Or okay. Am I wrong? The accuracy is no, at this level.
Yeah, this one is a previous BS theory result, and this one is our result, and the accuracy is improved by maybe three order.
Yeah.
Two or three order, yes.
Yes,